Welcome back to Pillars of Eternity. I'm the RPG Chick. We're, explored almost all of Deerfoot Crossing. We've apparently got the key to this broken statue thing. I don't know, that might open a dungeon or it does something, I don't know. We'll find out, because I haven't used it yet. So, I do want to explore the rest of the zone before we do that. Killed a bunch of worms. Wasn't hard at all after fighting drakes. Oh, there's more dead worms. Someone's been killing them. Oh. But not all of them. Before I choose my target, let me head for... Oh, there's somebody over here. Elijah and Sevis. Okay, let's... If these are friendly people, let's not... allow them to be killed, and let's kill this worm. Unless they like the worms, and then they won't be happy with us. And, matter of fact, go for this one. There's three of them. We're newly rested, though, and at full strength, so beware.
Brave Dalphilocule.
No! Hit this one.
That's it!
And not damaging that much so far.
But
oh, they kind of missed out on that one. Oh, they destroyed that one. Oh, nice. Alright, we're gonna go all range on this one. They're not advancing.
That's it!
Come on, Kanna, clean your gun. Got him. Cool. This is like the first battle I've waged completely with ranged weapons. That was pretty neat. Bunch of worm wings. Well, let's clear out this section and head towards these people over here.
Hello? Hello?
He was doing that. Yes, hello, Kanna. We're paying attention to you. No need to fear. There was, ooh, another forest lurker. I remember those. Those were really tough back in the day. Let's see how we fare now. I'm sure they'll still be rather tough. Two of them. Yeah, we're gonna have to be careful. Oh, I thought we had ranged enabled. Oh, we've got a pogra, two pogras. And three of the frickin' things. This is gonna be interesting. Amplified thrust off of... who's up here? Durance is in front? Durance, I guess. That should not be, though. Okay. Holy Radiance. Knockdown. Now we'll choose this guy. Flames of something on that guy. Oh boy. Canna M injured. Where is Canna? Durance? Where is he? Oh, he's right here. I didn't even see him up there. Okay, amplified thrust off of Canna. Try to get that guy off in a little bit. And yeah, again. Fireball. Love that fireball, man. This guy's wandering off. Canna's tied to this one, isn't he? Palagina, where are you? I don't see her. She's all the way back here. You're not doing anything. I'm trying to have her come about. Hit that. Oh, we're there? You're just running all over the place now? Hit him. Canna's right there. Restore Major. Oh yeah, get this small wind blight out of here. What the hell? I did not invite that. So many I can target without hurting ourselves. Alright, we're out of that. Concussive missiles on that. Attack that. Dare. Where's Palagina? I didn't see anybody. There you go. Dare. Dare, that's Palagina. Dare. Knockdown. He's still casting his minor missile. He's still casting it. He's all the way back here. Good. One down. That one's near death, so let's not waste it and cast it here. Knockdown.
Quay.
Quay? Oh boy. I didn't notice him getting so far down here. That's basically all for you, Canna. Did we get rid of that one? I guess we did. That's a dare. Look at that. Get rid of that thing. boy. Some healing over there. Necrotic Lance on that.
Yeah.
Garu, be on seat.
Oh boy. Getting banged up here. Kana, I'm having a hard time keeping up with you here. He is attacking, right? Just making sure. Get rid of that guy.
Love, Baru, be on seat.
More healing. Huh. Near death. Please to bring the death. Let's hope we kill it before Kana goes down, because I'm going to heal Adair. Alright, do we have time? He's still casting. Yeah. Gohan's pledge for myself. Theodess, rather. Oh! Kana technically is still alive.
What?
Cast that
Get
spell!
Blood!
Oh boy, nope, he's down. And I'm down? Holy crap! Okay, those forest lurkers are almost dead. Not good. Reviving exhortation. I'd say she's closer to Adair than me, right? Where am I? Well, I'm right here. Alright. Yeah, raise me. Get this Pogra. She's still doing that. Technically. This is a pretty tough battle. Okay, let's see if we can get rid of this guy. Can we throw out a quick blessing? How quick is blessing? Average? We need all the help we can get right now. Okay, one down. One more down, anyway. Oh boy. Getting banged up. Good, down. Who's Palagina fighting this thing? You kill it already. Good, down. Throw another heal.
That's it.
Would we get rid of that? Okay, good. All we've got left is this one. Pile on him. That means everybody pile on him. Wow, that was tough. That was tough. Wow. Awakened wood. Huh. Awaken this. Another felled adventurer. Evidently we've explored everything though. Boots of the Long March. Plus 15 max endurance and plus 2 athletics. These boots bear the rising son of Aethys, and they were first worn by a foot soldier in St. Widwin's army. The daughter of poor Vorlas farmers, she was sickly and frail all of her life. Yet such was her devotion to Aethys that, when the Red Saren army marched on the Deerwood, she set off to join them against her family's warnings, traveling all the way to the White March on her own. When she finally arrived at the army's camp, it is said that St. Widwin himself came out to greet the young woman, blessing her for her courage and endurance. Her boots were branded with the emblem of his army, and she continued across the mountains with the troops. She disappeared, however, after the detonation of the Godhammer. Historians and folklorists disagree on whether she died in the explosion, remained in the Deerwood, or met another fate on her way back to Red Saris. She met another fate... Sorry. Wait. Or met another fate on her way back to Red Saris, but her boots somehow remained behind. Aethys' faithful often maintain that she ascended with the god himself at the end of the war, leaving only the shoes that served her so faithfully. Hmm. Anyone need any boots? She's got Fulvano's boots. Kanna doesn't have any boots. Yeah, Kanna needs boots. It's Kanna. Hold on a second, guys. Okay. Let's make sure there's nothing.
I'll see what I can find.
Secret around here. I hate to say it, I think we should rest again in case these people standing over here are not friendly after all. So let's set up camp and keep watch if they come around. Let's see if these guys ever sleep or they're still standing there. I guess we'll just stop sneaking then. Nope, they don't sleep. Hail! Huh. Sevis, a man turns to face you, wiping blood from his estoc. His knit brows betray a moment of confusion, but as he watches you, a slow, confident smile creeps across his face. The Iron Brand does not meet many travelers this far from the road. What would they be doing out here? Ralph? An elven man cocks his head at the other. Probably after that dragon egg. Same as us, boss. Huh, what we got here? A band of mercenaries? Norgar. A dwarf curses and spits into the grass. It's a rhetorical question, you dimwit. He tightens his grip on his sword. Everyone knows the roads between the villages are crawling with brigands. They're obviously bandits, same as us. Okay, they've just identified themselves as bandits. Why would you want a dragon egg? Huh, to sell it, of course, Sevis says. If I wanted to eat it, I would have grabbed some pigs from that farm in Deerford, too. What do you know about the dragon eggs? He shrugs. They are round and large, and they come from dragons and drakes. What else is there to know? Should we lie and use our intellect? Our superior intellect? Why not? Only the drakes mark their eggs, so you'd better hope you've sold it to the next poor sod before the mother comes looking for it. The other bandits whisper amongst each other. The leader holds up his hand. Quiet! You can't seriously believe this, and even if it is true, we'll sell it before that happens. Elfia says, I'm not taking any chances with drakes. Say what you want. I'm out. She hurries off. All right, well, at least we don't have to fight her, I guess. Sevis says, let her go. That just means a bigger cut for us. Okay, so we gotta fight the rest. Norgar, Sevis, Ralph, and Blissa, who's said nothing during the whole ordeal. All right. If it's a fight you guys want, we'll gladly provide it. Except for this Norgar guy, I guess. Range attack. Let's see if she can take over this. I don't know who that is. Blissa? We'll try it. Oh, we have to wait for combat to start. Now combat started. Okay. Holy Radiance. Let's see if we can do this. Puppet Master. Let's see if we can control this Blissa. If she's a sorcerer type, she'll probably resist. Alright, I say we start off with concussive missiles on this leader here.
What?
Oh boy. Getting banged up already, kinda. Oh, we're chopping him to pieces. Alright. Blissa's badly injured. Oh, wait. No, attack him. She is on our side, I think. Oh, she just turned back. Take that! That other lady's lucky that she ran off. An exceptional estoc. A fine greatsword, fine breastplate, fine leather armor, fine scale armor, a stag helm, 3 potions of minor regeneration, and assorted gold and silver coins. I have plenty of potions that I don't even use now, so. Anyway, let's sneak around.
I shall be discreet.
Look for secrets. Perhaps we'll find this egg after all. A pistol. Alright, I can't. And fine padded armor. I found the abandoned roost perched atop a cliff in the northeast area of Deerford Crossing. It looks like a difficult climb. I may want to check my supplies before I attempt it. Well, we have grappling hooks and stuff like that. Yep. There she goes. So probably have to fight that drake. The cliff face is blackened and melted like candle wax. There's a small outcropping overhead with what appears to be a crude nest. It looks like a challenging climb. Hurl a grappling hook to the outcropping. Oh, we lost it. You toss the grappling hook over the edge, holding the attached rope with one hand. The hook lands with a satisfying clang, and you secure the line with a firm tug. So we've lost the grappling hook, but you have to remember to get more. We might have one more, I'm not sure. You take another look at the cliff. There may only be space for one person at the top. Send a dare. He's the toughest one. He might get into a drake battle by himself. The rope makes for a quick ascent. Adair climbs to the nest in the cliff with ease. The nest is surrounded by glowing embers. Twigs and bones litter the area. An egg the size of a small keg is nestled among the detritus. It looks heavy and awkward to carry. Good idea. Secure the egg with a rope and lower it. We've lost another one, so we did have another one. Adair ties a rope around the egg. Adair lowers the egg with slow, steady motions. Once the prize has reached the bottom and settles into the dirt, Adair safely climbs down the cliff. Yay! No drake battle? I got the egg down the cliff without a scratch. Indina should be able to get a lot of use out of it. Awesome. Pretty freaking awesome. Alright, we still have to explore the top area. It doesn't look like we're gonna get here this episode, guys. Sorry, but I am looking forward to it. Definitely. I just want to be thorough. Finish off our exploration of one area before we continue on. Can I cross here, or is this a dead end? Oh, I can't cross here. Nope. This is going to be stupid. We're going to be passing right by it, but I'm a little OCD about such things. It's pretty cool. We got that egg. I wonder if we can look at it. It's bound to be in quest items. This dragon egg is a mottled gold color and warm to the touch. It is in perfect condition. Awesome. Can't go around that way. Let me just use it and see what happens. Try the skull-handled key. The key slides easily into the socket. You turn it and the ruined statue begins to move. The displaced pedestal reveals a dark passage descending into the earth.
After you, I insist.
I knew it. I knew that's what it would be, but we're not heading down there yet, guys. Finish exploring here. Oh, we have to head across again.
Slowly now.
Unveiling the fog of war before us. More pilgrim's crown. It's very common around these here parts. There's a deer. Where is this leading us, this trail here? Oh, nothing. Yeah, there's nothing around here. Surprising. This place is crawling with beetles and spiders and stuff. But they're not over there.
I'll see what I can find.
There's a wood beetle. What do we have selected? Okay. Ranged.
Eh?
These beetles travel rather quickly. Hit them. I just saw a minor missile over in that direction. Amplified thrust off of Canna. And the deer will watch. Observe, deer.
Hey.
Poison!
I think we'll be okay against them. Canna. Dare. Knockdown. Palagina's. She's engaged with this one, so finish this one. Activated. I don't see any reason to use this stuff. So where is he? Is he in endurance? Can you walk over here and hit this one? Boom. Boom. Okay, now we can use that. And flight thrust off of Palagina. This is a dare. Knock down this one.
I'm ready.
I'm not sure if she'll make it through all these guys, so let's go here. Not trouble anyway. Tough as a stone beetle.
That's not.
I know Ken is messed up, but. The battle is almost over.
Help
me. Okay. Beetle shells. Let's finish off the map.
Margarine's fire casts light in dark places.
That he does. Or that it does. Or something does. Arath spell. Done. These are just shadows. I can't get in the water to get rid of this crap, which bothers me. Hey, but what are you gonna do? Head back over. I turned sneaking off, I thought. There we go. Okay. So, stay tuned for next episode when we enter a broken statue dungeon. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.